These children from Gainsborough Junior School are about to start a new project, as their teacher, Mr. Jennison, explains.
We're going to go into school and we're going to design a garden. I want it to be your ideal garden, what you would do if you had lots and lots of choices and you can put anything in this one area. But first of all, we've got to think about its shape, and I want you to look around you and think about one or two things that might determine the shape we choose. These two big trees behind you, we're very, very near to the fence. You saw when I was trying to dig out this sod how hard it was to dig it up. So all those kinds of things have got to be considered when you actually do your perfect design.
Most of the flowers in my garden flower in either spring or summer. I like my garden to be colourful.
I want my garden to have some herbs and a jungle and a greenhouse.
In my ideal garden, I would have nettles and bright flowers to attract butterflies. In the middle, there would be a maze with flowers around it.
Around the edge of the garden, I would have some daffodils and tulips.
A sundial with some raised beds around it with alpine plants growing in it.
In my garden, I would like lots of flowers and a small area for vegetables.
Now, Jordan, can anyone tell me what these are? Kate?
Violas.
Violas. Now, what we want to do is to try and set up some experiments where we can find out something about the growing of these violas. What I want to do is to ask for volunteers to take these plants to various parts of the school and try and make up different growing conditions for them. Who would like to do that?
A week later, the children had a look at their plants. The results were dramatic.
Hello, Bridgemere Garden World, John Ravenscroft speaking.
Hello, this is Emma Teale from Gainsborough County Junior School. We want to plant a garden and we've been doing some experiments on some plants, but they're all dying, so can you help us, please?
I see. So the result of your experiments was that quite a lot of the plants died or look ill. Well, bring them along for us to have a look at, and maybe we can help you and take it from there.
Mr. Ravenscroft?
Yes, I am.
We've been doing some experiments at our school to see how plants grow. Could you help?
Well, you've not been very successful with this one, have you? So let's have a look. It's very short of water. So we can tell by the weight. Now, this hasn't luckily gone so far that we can't revive it, but it's very nearly there. This has definitely come on hard times. This one, what have you done to this one?
Put it in the fridge.
Now, if it had been in your fridge temperatures in the winter, it would have been all right. But what's happened is that this plant thought it was spring, and it is spring, you can see. And all of a sudden, you take it from growing soft in the spring weather, and you stick it in the fridge, and all of a sudden, it's winter again. So they won't stand that, and nothing will.
This one's been in a dark cupboard.
Yes, well, what's happening here is that the leaf joints are getting further apart, aren't they? And this is lack of light.
This one's had its roots cut off.
Has it? Goodness me, I used to cut worms up when I was little. Now, without its root, with which it takes up water, no plants can live, really. Plants need sunlight, fresh air, water, and particularly important is to see what's in the soil. So go and have a look at your own soil, see what you can find out about it, but also you've got to look at your plot and find out where it faces north, what faces south, so where the sun will be and won't be, and also how windy it is.
Over there.
51147.
Hello, Agricultural Development and Advisory Service. Claire Strite speaking. How can I help you?
I'm from Gainsborough County Junior School. We're trying to find out more about our soil. Could you help us?
The first thing that you must do is to dig a hole, a reasonable sized hole that goes down to about 30 centimetres in depth. And then we will arrange an appointment to come along, have a look at the structure of the soil in the hole, and I will bring a soil scientist with me.
Now, before we have a look at your hole, I'd like you to just have a look at some of these soils that I've brought along, and then we'll see how these soils compare to your soil in the hole and help you to make a decision about what sort of soil you've got. So that's very sandy.
It's all sand and
yeah,
not right. Much soil.
And why do you think it's, how do you know it's sandy?
Because of the colour.
Colour, yeah, what else?
It feels sandy. What, it's very, very fine.
Yeah.
Have a few lumps of this one. Tell me what you think of this one.
Clayy.
Ah, how do you know it's clay?
It's just the way it forms.
Yeah. Hard. What does it feel? Sticky, yes, that's a nice way of putting it. Yeah.
Hard.
Now, when you get down below the topsoil, where the plant's going to grow in this topsoil here, and then down below, you're going to go into a different material, and this is going to decide how wet the soil is going to be. Now, if we pass a bit of this round, can we just have a look at this? If you can try and wet that up, please, and see what you think of that. Can you tell me whether that? Tell me whether that's...
Clay.
Yeah.
It's like clay.
Is it? So when you get it wet, it's going like clay. So you've got a very wet soil. So when you go to choose your plants, you mustn't choose plants that like freely drained soils.
So the children must select plants that grow in wet clay soil. Now they need to find out how much acid is in it.
Now we've got a little colour chart here, and basically if it's green, it isn't acid, and if it goes very red, it's very acid. So what I'd like to do with you is just take a small sample of the soil, and we'll apply some of this fluid to it, and just see what colour we get at the end of it. There's your soil. And what we'll do is just put a bit of this material on it and we'll just lightly shake it in there and we'll see if it changes colour. Now, if it doesn't change colour, if it stays around about the green colour, you haven't got an acid soil. It would only be if it went towards the red side here that you'd have an acid soil. And this is only changing colour slightly. From the dark green there, it's going slightly lighter. It's probably somewhere between this and this here. So it's not an acid soil by any means. So it means that when you go to choose your plants, you mustn't buy plants that like acid soils.
Armed with this information about their plot of land, the children set off for the garden centre.
Hello, Mr. Ravenscroft.
Hello, Nicola.
We've done what you said to do.
Good, let's have a look at it. I see, that's the north. Oh, I can understand this now.
Well, this... our garden's at the north end of the school, but it's still got plenty of sun, because it isn't really facing any direction. This is the bit that we want to cultivate. Left this bit grass because of the manhole cover, and we've got some trees there.
Well, you've all... now come to look around and see what plants we've got at Bridgemere, and you've learnt quite a bit now about what plants need. All our plants at Bridgemere have got information in front which tells you how big they get, what colour they flower, when they do it, and what they like.
At the school, a plot of land was being prepared for planting. While inside, the children made their final choice of trees, shrubs, plants, and flowers for their garden.
Can we borrow it, please?
Yes.
Doesn't have to be. That's it, just mark them.
Garden, we'd like some shrubs around the fence for a wind block and some insect and butterfly attracting plants, some colourful perennials, and maybe a rock garden in the southwestern corner.
All in that little patch? Well, obviously you need those plants, those shrubs on the boundary to break the force of the wind from the north and also the turbulence from passing traffic. I don't think you really need the rock garden because it wouldn't look credible on that site. A little pile of rocks in the middle of this alkaline clay soil couldn't have happened in nature, could it? So the plants that you want to grow on there can grow with good drainage without the rocks. So I'd like you to go all off now round the garden centre and pick the plants that you like.
On a spring day in May, the children finally planted their garden. By July, it was in full bloom.